Okay, so we applied the glossy laminate to our graphics. So the next step in our process of production is to actually cut the image out. So in order to do that, we're going to load the material onto our cutter and then cut the graphics out. Okay, so the material is all cut. We take it off the cutter. And the next step, we're going to do some weeding. Okay, so as we mentioned, the material has been cut. So the next thing that we're going to do is weed out the images so that the only thing remaining are just our graphics. So in order to do that, we have a couple tools, our knife, and we also have our poker so that we can pull the material out accurately. And what you'll see when we're done is just the remaining images. And then we'll go to the next step, which is called masking. So we're gonna cut the images apart to separate them just to make the weeding easier. And then what we have to do is actually pull out the excess film so that only our graphic designs are remaining on the page. So depending on the image, that can be very detailed and time-consuming. But these graphics here, there's not a ton of detail based on the way that they were designed. So that was the exterior part of these designs. Now we do have some little cutouts that will expose the color of the machine that we also have to weed away or pull this material out. And that's one of the reasons that they call it weeding. We've done the weeding now. So what we have remaining are just the graphics now on the page. So the next step, so that we can actually apply the graphics onto the machine, is applying the transfer tape. So the transfer tape, basically what it does is it holds all the elements of the design together so that you can transfer it as one piece, all pre-spaced, and apply it onto the bike. So we'll put the transfer tape on the graphics.